Up until now, I've clocked over 2,000 kilometers, traveled to 11 states and 2 union territories. I traversed the highways, followed the stars, and drove different classes of Mercs. The B, the A, the E, the ML, the GL. Oh, I love the GL class. The point is, you can catch all my crazy adventures on Follow the Star. Welcome to Follow the Star. This week, I start my journey from Pune and drive into the heartland of Maharashtra. But before I headed out of the city, I had to take part in the ritual of picking up some delicious Shrewsbury biscuits from Kayani Bakery, which is an institution here.
Kayani Bakery on East Street seems to be stuck in a time warp. It was established by a local Parsi family in the city and has been dishing out treats to travellers and locals alike since 1955. The bakery is a confectionery wonderland and its hottest selling item is the Shrewsbury biscuit. The bakery has an extensive menu that offers an array of biscuits, cakes and breads, and every Puneite has their very own personal favourite. The trick is to get in bright and early in the morning to get that scrumptious oven-fresh box of cookies.
So one for the road.
I start my journey from Pune, where I slip onto the State Highway 60 before taking a detour to State Highway 54 to explore a natural wonder at Nighoj. I then get back on the SH60 and follow it till the end of my journey in Aurangabad. En route, I make a pit stop at Ahmednagar to check out the famous Ahmednagar Fort.
I'm driving on the Maharashtra State Highway 60, which runs northeast from Pune to Aurangabad. Since the train link takes 3 to 4 hours, it's always better to take the road because you can complete the distance in a little under 2 hours. The road conditions here have left me pleasantly surprised. It's a 4-lane highway with fairly good roads, except that in patches you will find crowded settlements that slow down traffic.
I've just crossed the town of Shirur, and I have to look out for an exit on my left, which will get me on to the State Highway 54.
From here, I'm taking a left that detours to Nighoj. It's a small hamlet with a natural wonder I wouldn't want to miss.
The road to Nighoj is not much fun to drive on as it's narrow, dusty and sparsely populated, but I'm super excited about the potholes along the Kukari riverbed and I'm not going to let the road conditions dampen my spirits. Situated 3 kilometers ahead of the village of Nighoj, the Kukari river flows seamlessly through the rocky terrain with temples on either side of its bed. Though at first glance, the place looks rather unflattering, but I'm going to give it a second chance and get a closer look. Locally known as Kund, these naturally created potholes have baffled geologists from the world over for decades, who come here every year to study them. It is believed that the once peacefully flowing river has been relentlessly beating against the hard basalt rock bed for countless years, giving rise to this geological vignette. These potholes are spread over 3 kilometers and 100 meters deep, giving the basin the look of a canyon.
This is said to be one of the largest natural gorges in Asia, and the view is quite amazing. They look like craters on the moon. The incredible thing about nature is it never ceases to amaze you.
Though I could sit here and marvel at this geological wonder for hours, the road beckons me and I must move on. I'm back on the State Highway 60 and this road is drastically different from the one I was driving on my way to Nighoj. The road is a four-lane highway and I'm having a great time driving my Mercedes E250 on it.
My first pit stop is here, Ahmednagar, and my pick of the city is the Ahmednagar Fort.
Of Ahmed Nizam Shah, Ahmednagar is dotted with several Mughal era buildings. The most popular of them is the Ahmednagar Fort. The fort stands tall as Ahmed Nizam Shah's victorious conquest of the Daulatabad Fort. Today, the fort is a popular tourist attraction and is a must visit for any history enthusiast. Leaving the Ahmednagar fort behind, I continue my journey to my final destination, Aurangabad.
Aurangabad is about 60 kilometers from here and my drive has been great thanks to my Mercedes E250.
Coming up on Follow the Star, I explore ancient art and architecture at the historic city of Aurangabad. See you after the break.